About a year ago, I had the crazy idea to put a massive culvert bunker behind my house. You can't see it now, but I dug a huge hole and hoisted a 12-foot diameter tube into the air with a crane and placed them 20 feet below the grass to build a rather cool bunker in my backyard. It's actually literally cool, since the temperature below ground is about 30 degrees cooler than the temperature above ground. The problem is that currently there is no auto-replenishing energy source for long-term habitation, which is where today's bifacial solar panels come in, meaning they can collect sunlight from the back and the front, along with a 400-watt wind turbine. It's kind of crazy, even though I know the bunker is strong enough to be buried 100 feet underground with millions upon millions of pounds of dirt on top, it's still kind of weird to see two full-size super trucks parked on top of my bunker. I worked with Ridge to plate this Cybertruck in real 24 karat gold, and thanks to Ridge for sponsoring this video, the giveaway got even bigger. One lucky winner is going to be able to pick between the world's only real gold Cybertruck or a fully decked out Hennessy Velociraptor. Or if those don't suit your fancy, you can pick $100,000 in cash. It is all happening right now, and you can enter for free. I will leave a link in the video description. Entering for free is great, but if you want even more entries and more chances to win, for every dollar you spend on the Ridge website through that special link in the description, you'll get one additional entry. 100 bucks equals 100 entries. And if you purchase either the Cyber Wallet or the Hennessy branded gear through that same link, you will get 4 times the entries. There's the potential to win one of 2 super trucks or $100,000 cash, but you also just get a solid wallet. I've been using this burnt titanium Ridge wallet for the past 5 years. Time is limited though. Get your entries in before September 13th with the link in the description, and let me know in the comments which prize you would choose. The fully electric gold Cybertruck or the gas-powered Velociraptor, or just the cold hard cash. Let me know, and may the odds be ever in your favor. In order to make a solar-powered bunker hatch, we basically have to manufacture the world's largest sliding drawer. In the same way your kitchen drawer slides in and out, these solar paddles have to do the same thing. We've got some Unistrut from the hardware store, we have some Unistrut rollers capable of holding 2,000 pounds, and of course, lasers. One of the coolest parts for me, at least, on this backyard bunker build is that the whole thing is just a really big, really complex DIY project. And at first it might not seem like bringing a $1 million metal cutting laser into play is very DIY, but this particular $1 million laser is owned by Oshcut, and can technically be used by anyone. Oshcut doesn't pay me to say these things, they're just literally my next door neighbor, and I've been a patron of their services for almost 4 years now. I took some of our 3D design files and uploaded them onto Oshcut's website, and got perfectly cut and bent pieces to build our hatches with. I find it fascinating to watch, and then we can assemble everything back next door at my own shop. We would normally be doing all this construction in my garage, but currently most of my tools have been hijacked by the guys at my wheelchair factory, and I have yet to reclaim them. These Unistrut rollers are really the key that makes this whole contraption function. We're trimming them down and modifying them a bit, and locking 4 of the rollers together with a rod. We're assembling 2 large shapes, structurally solid, sliding solar surfaces that simultaneously sandwich the solar panels. It's a shell that safely slips smoothly shut while stockpiling some shiny sunlight. It'll all make more sense when you see it completed here in a few minutes. My backyard bunker has 2 openings, one large shaft, which is going to receive the sliding solar panels, and then a much smaller shaft. It's more of an emergency exit, and we've left it in disarray. With just some pieces of extremely heavy metal covering the opening.
I don't know if you can see this or not, but there's a cobweb right there. Spiders.
If you remember way back when the bunker was underground and we had to cut out the rear door for the exit shaft.
That weighs so much.
That's this door right here, and we're gonna cut off more slivers of it to kind of seal off the entrance so that our hatch doesn't have to be as big as the shaft itself. We really should have done this a long time ago, but better late than never. The slivers we cut from the scrap piece brings the full opening of the exit shaft down to a much more manageable hatch opening. And if I had to do this all again, I would have just made this transition occur deeper underground, so we would have less metal and less visible surface area above ground, but I'm not about to dig the whole thing up again just to redo the shaft. To make the hatch open, we're using a little gizmo called a weldable bullet hinge, or barrel hinge. It's got a cute little greasable zerk fitting. It's super strong and inexpensive, and depending on how you orient the interior pin, the door can either be removable or permanently attached forever.
Alright, set her on. It's dark. Okay.
We're adding some angle iron to the top of the hatch. You'll see what this is for in a second. And I'll clean the rust that's accumulated over the past 6 months and cover the exposed metal with some waterproof paint. Again, something we should have done a long time ago, but better late than never. At this point, we'll also get the ground level with the top of the hatch. I'll put some grass seed here later. To conceal and make the industrial metal square a bit more backyard friendly, I'll apply copious amounts of glue, specifically mulch glue, which apparently is a real thing. It's a landscaping adhesive very similar to transparent wood glue, which is still very permeable, while permanently securing mulch to a very specific area. I could probably put turf or even pavers over this top as well, but for now we're trying the mulch glue and a rather large fake rock, which we can secure to the trap door with that bracket we installed earlier, along with a little piece of treated lumber. The rock gives us a little more of an aesthetic entry point than what we had before.
No one will ever know there's a bunker there.
Right, Tyson? Being so close to the playset, I imagine we'll have kids playing on this rock, so I'm adding some expanding foam to support the rock on either side of that piece of wood. Is this gonna work long term? I have no idea. This is my first bunker and I'm not an expert on fake rocks. With the exit shaft lid taken care of, it's now time for the sliding solar entry shaft. The secret with this side is obviously the unistrut, which we can weld directly to the 6x6 square of our bunker opening. The slider has two levels, since the top level needs support to get that full extension. Our solar panels will need to slide completely away from the entry so that the elevator can still move up and down. Unistrut is a standardized framing system used all over the place in electrical and plumbing industries, but I think this sliding bunker door made out of unistrut is probably a world's first. With four stacked pieces of the unistrut on either side and 16 of these modified unistrut rollers, which have 128 individual bearings, but who's counting? Our frame can start taking shape and sliding completely away, exposing the whole 20-foot hole deep in the ground. To keep the rails from sliding too far and the rollers from popping out of the open ends, we can take quarter 20 bolts with nylock nuts and make our own stops.
Perfect. All right, moment of truth. Tyson, slide it out, see what happens. That's sweet. So we're gonna take that solar panel and put it here, another solar panel here with acrylic on top. But it looks like,
so far we have been successful. Now, solar panels are super strong, don't get me wrong. Most solar panels these days are designed to withstand at least 1-inch balls of hail falling at 50 miles per hour. However, I know for absolute certain that with these panels being ground mounted, people are going to step on them. So I need things way more secure than just one single layer of strong glass. Because as we know, glass is glass. We've designed the frame so that the two 320-watt bifacial solar panels get recessed inside of the rectangular openings, while leaving some room around the edges for airflow. And then we can cut 3/4-inch acrylic sheets to lay on top of that frame. Acrylic sheets like this are the same stuff they use in bulletproof glass, so I'm feeling pretty confident in their structural capabilities. Plus, since we partnered with SolidWorks, we did a finite element analysis in CAD to see how much weight the thick acrylic could hold. And the FEA said that it can withstand over 1,000 pounds in any given spot.
Wow, it got a lot darker in here.
We could probably park a car with one tire on top and it would still hold, but that's not a durability test I want to try just yet. These solar panels were about $300 each. If you want to dip your own toes into SolidWorks, they do have SolidWorks for Makers at just $12 a month. I'll put a link down in the description.
So we have the two pieces of acrylic, super thick. And then this is going to go back on top of it to cinch everything in place.
And guards the unistrut rails to help keep the sprinklers from spraying directly into the bunker. It's not a big deal if they do, of course, since we have drains and a very low water table here in Utah. Nice. Not gonna lie, the bifacial panels look super cool up there. I'll clean up the wires later, but if we come over here, we are currently generating almost 200 watts worth of solar, but it is super early in the morning and I imagine that we would get around 400, 450 when the sun is directly overhead. Having the panels flat does decrease our efficiency a bit, but those two solar panels should be enough to power everything down here that we need perpetually. Moment of truth, we're gonna see if the solar panel hatch can support what, 600 pounds worth of weight? Cause there's kids in the backyard and we wanna make sure that it's safe for them. Cue the intense music. $200, $600. Safe to say, Nate and Tyson, we've built it very strong. I don't know what else to say about that.
More than 600.
Yeah,
you sliding it? This feels weird. All right, I'm out of here. So there you have it, a perfectly concealed, exquisitely hidden fake rock over the exit shaft and solar panels over the entrance shaft. We now have a very secure bunker that is infinitely powered forever as long as the sun is shining. We didn't have time in this video to put up the windmill, but I will put that up on top of the barn back here and pipe. I'm gonna do some non-potable water from the rain collection system. It's gonna be, we have a lot going on. Don't forget to enter the Ridge Wallet giveaway with a link in the description, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.